number four, now we're talking about marketing. Now we're talking about taking the content, the website, the conversion systems, the brand, and making it visible to humans. We just got to marketing. So, here's the beauty. That's not. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Once you understand the mathematics behind the reality of marketing, you can predict the future. I have the ability, our team, anybody who has the data, has the ability to look for any service someone would search for, city they would search for it, and look at how many people are looking for it. That's a number. So if you go launch in a new city, and there's only 400 searches per month, and you're expecting to do $50,000 per month in that area, that's not real, right? This is part of setting clarity or the original expectations is understanding for each service and city combination, what are the total monthly searches? The reality is they're a lot less than most people think, which means we need a broader base of different kinds of searches in different kinds of cities. Based on the total number of searches, there is an impression share. Based on how many positions you own on page one of Google, the percent of eyeballs seeing your company as an option changes. If you are on page one of Google in the organic area and you're number 8, versus if you're number 1, and you're on the Google map, and you have an ad, and you're in the LSA, the percentage, or the Google ads, local service ads, the percentage of eyeballs from that search goes up. Does that make sense? The percent of people who have the opportunity to even see you goes up. If you have a click-through rate of 3%, you can literally predict the future. I know there are 10 searches in this area for this search term. I know that my percent or impression rate, the percent of people that see my company, is X percent. I know 3% of those people will click to my website. I know X percent of those people will leave, bounce. That's a bounce rate. I know X percent of those people will take action, convert. They move from suspect to prospect. And I know that my CSRs and technicians convert to customer X percent of those. And I know for that service in that city, my average ticket price is X. My average margin is X. I know how much money I can make in any city, anywhere, anytime. Does that make sense? Okay. When you're first starting out, we're not there yet, right? Because you got a long ways to climb. If there's a million pages in front of you, you need to be in the top 10 of those million. You only have a couple ways to get there. You could pay for it. You could earn it. Pay for it, paid ads and LSAs. Earn it, SEO. And Google business listing if you have a business verified in that city. Otherwise, it's not an option. That's the reality of your options. What do you want to sell? Where do you want to sell it? Are you an option on page one of Google? How many people are looking for it? Of the people looking for it, what percent of the share do you get eyeballs looking at your company? Are you represented on Google Local Service Ads, Google AdWords, Google Maps, and in the top 10 first page results, SEO? Of that, what is your click-through rate? How good is your promotion? Do you offer financing? Do you have the best discounts? Do you have the best promotions? Is it easy for you to be able to convert? How many people leave? Bounce. How many people take action? They text, they call, they schedule, they chat. They fill out a web form. How many of you love filling out web forms? Contact us form. 0. But everyone in here has a contact us form on their website. It's the primary form on every single website, and not any audience or any focus group likes to fill out that form. There's lots of oxymorons that don't help.